بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. This video a humble message to my respected brother Ali Luqman Khan. Today I saw a segment called Women in the Mosque or in the Masjid. And the person who uploaded say funny, Nu'man Ali Khan. This is Zul Furqar Ali Khan. I'm not going to question what the people wrote because this is not your writing funny. But I'm questioning the information. And I come to you, I understand, as a Muslim brother. My name is Muhammad Said Adli. They call me Sheikh Adli, but I'm not coming to you as a Sheikh. I'm seeking information because what I heard in this segment concerning women in the mosque or in the masjid is a little bit strange to me, and I really don't know where I can find it. So I'm asking your assistance and your help that you let me know from where you get this information, your story behind the hadith. And if I'm not mistaken, you're talking about the hadith of Humayd al-Sa'idi. And you're saying about a woman used to pray and her husband used to poke her or tickle her or touch her while she's making salah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, and she said she stole my surah. And after this, the story keep going, that the Prophet told her to pray in the closet, so it will be so dark. So use this your justification for why a woman or why the Prophet says such a hadith. Kindly, if you be kind enough and tell me where did you find such information? Because the hadith, to the limited of my knowledge, it has no any occasion other than Humayd al-Sa'idi. She came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, O Messenger of Allah, innu uhibbu salata ma'ak, I love to pray behind you. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I know, qad alimtu annaki tuhibbina salata ma'i. Yeah, I know that you love to pray behind me, but your salah, your prayer in your house is more rewarded. خير لك من صلاتك في حجرتك. Praying in your house is more rewarded and much better than praying in your room. And your prayer in your bedroom, which is in your house, is much better or more rewarded than your prayer in the mosque of your local community. And your salah in your local community mosque is more rewarded than your salah in the mosque, the bigger mosque. As a result of this, she commanded, فأمرت فبني لها مسجد في أقصى شيء من بيتها وأظلمه فكانت تصلي فيه حتى لقيت الله. So as a result of this, she issued a command for building a closet in the darkest place in her house, and she continued praying in it until she passed away. So I don't, unless you have a different hadith, my dear respected brother Ali, Nu'man Ali Khan. So I'm asking you, humble, that you can lead me to where you found such information. Because if not, we're going to have a different talk about this issue. Because seem you attributing something to the Prophet that is not authentic, or I'm not aware about it, not I'm claim that I know all the information. So I'm asking you, inshallah, humbly, for the sake of Allah, that you let me know where did you got this information, so I can, inshallah, check it out. Because this is a deen, is not a teen. This is a religion, is not a fig. It's not yours, it's not mine. It's the deen of Allah. And we have to sift the deen from all kind of stories, funny things that making people laugh and think that is funny, that is not authentic. Insha'Allah, I'll be waiting for your response. Jazakallahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.